Let's be honest, everyone loves RGB, so we added one on the microcade. In this video, I'm going to show you how to solder the RGB LED onto the microcade motherboard. So let's get started.
The first thing you want to do is grab the motherboard and the RGB LED from the little plastic bag that we found the buzzer and the switch. You can see it has four legs on it and it has a little transparent head on it, like so. As you can see, the longer pin means the positive pin, while the rest represent the R, G, and B. So the red, green, and blue LEDs. The first thing we're going to do is move the longer pin and the pin on the right of the longer pin forwards a little bit, like so. This will help just when we're fitting it onto the PCB. So align the longer pin with the plus on the PCB, and the pin to the right of the longer pin goes into the hole on the PCB next to the hole with the plus, like so. The two other pins, the ones that we pushed back, go into the two holes behind the plus pin. Now you can see it's a little bit hard to get in, but once you do, you just want to push it down till the bottom of the LED matches with the middle of the buzzer, like so. So you can see I just got like a little bit more to go, so I'm going to push it in a little bit more. And once I've fully pushed it in, like so, I'm just twisting it helps a little bit, moving it left and forwards and backwards. Once I've fully pushed it in, I'm going to pull those pins down. This will secure the RGB LED in place, like so, ready for us to solder it. So now you want to grab your soldering iron, grab the solder, and it's really important, as the pins are quite close together, you don't want to bridge them. So take your time and do one at a time. Try not to apply too much solder, as you can run the risk of actually bridging the pins. And they don't actually require too much solder. You can see the pads are actually a lot smaller than the pads that we had for the buzzer. So as you can see, I'm just soldering each pin as I go, making sure not to bridge them. Now that we're done soldering, these pins are quite long, so we're probably going to want to go ahead and grab our wire cutters and cut them. But to do that, we're going to flex the pins up using our thumb, and then we're going to grab the wire cutters and cut them short. Now again, you want to make sure that you're not cutting these too short, so you want to put the flat face of the cutters on the top of the soldering joint. Again, for safety reasons, once you're cutting these, just point them down, as those pins are going to fly out and they don't want them hitting your face. Now that we've done that, we can move on.